Hey guys, what's up? It's Gabi. Welcome to another video. In this video, we will be looking at Lightroom. And for the past few months since I started using Lightroom, I got really intense about it. I literally must have added hundreds of pictures. So keep watching, and at the end of this video, I am confident that you will be confident as well to start using and edit your pictures, whether it's travel ones or not, using Lightroom. Coming up. Okay, and Lightroom is a very powerful tool which I think you should use to edit your photos. So now, let's just jump into Lightroom, go through those basics, kind of like a reflection of what I've seen the first time I launched the application, and then at the end of the video, I will also throw in a little bit of a tip of how to crop your photos if you want to launch them on Instagram and you want them at like that resolution that looks the best, the coolest on every single post. Okay, and first of all, I kind of divided this into three sections that will be covered, and I named them the basic panels, the creative suite, and the creative delivery. Once you open Lightroom, the very first things that you are going to see are the panels at the top. And the first two are the ones that you are going to be the most interested in. So you're gonna have library, develop, map, book, slideshow, print, and web. The very first seconds that you're going to spend in Lightroom, you wanna import the pictures that you want to edit. So how you do that, you are going to click on library if it's not clicked already, and then a new panel will come up on the left side, which will include navigator, catalog, folders, collections, etc. So sometimes folders tab or the catalog tab might be hidden, you just gotta click on it. Then you're gonna have at the bottom import export. So obviously you wanna import the pictures first. So you're gonna click on the import button, and that's gonna bring up all the folders that you have, obviously pictures in, or just the folder of the hard drive. And then you're going to obviously select the folder that you want to bring into Lightroom with the pictures that you want to bring in the Lightroom. So for example, my folder is new edits to be done, just for a test purpose. So you want to make sure that if you want to import all the pictures, obviously all the photos box is ticked. If not, you can just select individually what you want to add in Lightroom. In this situation, I want to add all the pictures, so I'm going to click on the box and then I'm going to click import, and then this will bring the pictures into my library. So once I've done that, in order for me to kind of identify maybe some of the pictures I don't like them that much, maybe some of the pictures I feel like I want to edit them first. So a very cool thing about this is that you can actually rate your pictures in Lightroom. If you go to the panel at the bottom where you have the picture, so let's say I want to start with this picture to edit. So I'm going to click 5, and that's going to bring it to a rating of 5 stars. And I know in my head that I want to start with that picture. And then let's say I want to start with this one, the second. So I'm going to click 4, or okay, this is the best picture I have, I'm gonna bring it to 5 stars. If this picture I believe is not that great, I'm gonna put 4 stars or 3 stars, whatever you can rate your pictures, and that's a very cool thing. Now, how you edit them? You go to the panels at the top and you click on develop. And that is going to bring a new tab on the right side, which is the tab you want, which is the tab where you are going to create, you're gonna edit your amazing pictures as well, and then at the end you're gonna admire the work that you've done. But until then, let's run through the second section, which is, if you remember, the creative suite. Let's start from the very top and go through every single one so you can get a better understanding of what each one individually does. The first thing that you are going to see is the histogram. And I'll be totally honest with you, this is a useful tool that in most situations is very easily overlooked. And I think you're not gonna use it that much in the beginning. Just kind of blends in the sliders from the basic panels and the tones in your photos in a nutshell. So from left to right, you're gonna have the blacks, then you're gonna have the shadows, then you're gonna have the exposure, then the highlights, and then the whites. The next thing that you want to do is adjust your white balance. So you have this white balance selector here. Let's go and find a picture. So again, you go to library. So I've got these portraits. Let's take this one. So you gotta click again develop if you forgot. And what you want to do is pick up the white balance selector, which is this thing that looks like a bended Seattle tower, and then pick up a neutral color, click on it, and that will adjust the white balance of the picture. And now let's move back to the initial picture that we were looking at and look at the basic correction panel. And the first part of the basic correction panel is the tone panel. So you're gonna have the exposure, so you can kind of like set the exposure you want for the picture. You have the contrast, you have the highlights, you have the shadow. So you just literally just drag the slider back and forth to set up what you want. And this is, again, this is just solely depends on you, how you want your picture to look. For example, I like my pictures with a bit more detail in the shadow, so I'll kind of drop the shadows a little bit, also the whites and the blacks, etc. Now, a cool thing about it is that if you want to reset just one of them, you don't need to kind of like struggle to move back onto zero, etc. You just simply double click on it and it brings it back to zero. Okay, so after the tone panel, you're gonna have the presence panel. And I'll be honest with you, with this one, you're probably gonna play a lot, especially in the beginning when you start editing pictures. So you have clarity, dehaze, vibrance, and saturation. And this is very, very simple to understand. Clarity will simply add a lot more detail to your picture, but with the cost of sucking in a lot of its colors. Dehaze will basically add or remove haze to your picture, so it will kinda like add detail to the colors itself. If you pull it back, it will basically de-sharpen the colors. If you pull it up, it will basically sharpen the colors. Vibrance again lifts the colors of your picture. It will kind of give a bit of a natural feel. And saturation obviously just saturates or desaturates the color. This is a slider that, again, you are going to play a lot in the beginning, which in my opinion, just as clarity, it kind of ruins a bit the picture. If you want to give a bit more saturation to your colors, or you want to kind of lift that natural feel, I would drop the saturation and use the vibrance, and will kind of balance out in a nice way rather than using the saturation and literally just giving you a headache just looking at the picture because the colors are so bright. That's about it with the basic correction panel. Really easy stuff to kind of navigate through. And then we're moving down to the tone curve, which will essentially let you manipulate the highlights, the lights, the darks, and the shadows of your picture. And what I tend to do here, drop the shadows a little bit and lift the lights and the highlights. You wanna kinda have a bit of an S curve, but again, this is just down to you as a photographer, whatever, as an editor, when you edit your pictures, what's the feel you want to give to your pictures. And that's the tone curve explained for the purpose of this basic Lightroom tutorial. Of course, you can do a lot more with the tone curve, but it's no point throwing an abundance of information that you probably get confused. Let's move on from the tone curve panel and look at the HSL panel. And HSL is Hue, Saturation, Luminance. And this is probably the panel that you are going to spend the most time on. And it's also the panel that is going to define the vibe that you want to give, the contrast, where you want to take your picture. What essentially does is just lets you manipulate every single color of the picture. So let's start with hue, and you have the colors here, so you can change the color of the sky basically. So if you drag the slider towards the bottom, it will become a very aqua color, a very bright aqua color. If you drag it the opposite way, it will go towards purple, magenta. If you go to the saturation, this is self-explanatory. Again, you can just desaturate or saturate the colors that you choose to. So blue for this instance, you gotta drag the slider to the bottom, desaturate, drag the slider up, it will saturate the color. And then luminance, it will basically just give luminance to that specific color. So let's take for instance blue. So if you basically take the luminance away from blue, it will darken up the blue color. it will create more of a dramatic state of blue. If you increase the luminance, it will just completely brighten up the blue color to a state that will become white. Okay, so after the HSL tab, we are going to see the split toning. So essentially what this will do is just add hue and saturation to specific tone curves like highlights, shadows, if you want to add a bit of color to them. I don't personally use that much, and I don't think you will use it in the beginning either. Now, after we pass the split toning, you're gonna have the detail, and this is obviously the sharpening. Now, again, with this, I would be very, very careful. If you sharpen the image too much, and by the way, you will have to zoom. So if you go here where the navigator is and you press on fill or you press on 1:1, it will kind of zoom in the picture. And now you can really see how the picture will change when you use sharpening. So let's say I drag this all the way up. There is a bit more clarity and a bit more detail to these pillars here. You can also manipulate the radius of the sharpening and the detail and masking as well. After that, you're gonna have the noise reduction panel. So this is very, very simple to explain. Sometimes when you don't adjust the right settings of the camera or you don't have enough light, you get that kind of grain, that noise. So what this does is essentially helps you reduce that noise. Now let's move on from this, and you're gonna get to a tab which is the lens correction. And this tab I absolutely love. It's very, very smart. It's basically having a very sophisticated brain inside Lightroom application that kind of goes like, I recognize this. This was shot on a 15 to 35 mil lens. Essentially, you just want to click on enable profile corrections, choose the make, boom, straight away, it identifies the lens that this picture was taken with. And as you can see, brightens up a bit the edges of the picture and just adjusts overall the picture itself. So it's a very, very cool panel. I use this panel pretty much in the beginning when I start editing a picture. Okay, and the last panel that I'm going to actually touch in the Creative Suite is the effects panel. This would be another thing that you might use in the beginning. I don't personally use it that much. I do have a few pictures that I gave a bit of vignetting to them. You have the post-crop vignetting, so you can add some vignetting to your picture. So once you've obviously selected this and the amount, then you're gonna have, then you can use like the midpoint, how far you want the vignetting to go. So let's go here. So you see the midpoint is how far you want. Obviously you don't want this far, this looks shit. But essentially you can, yeah, just add some vignetting, and then you can add some grain to your picture as well. So as you can see, this grainy feel, and you can choose the size and the roughness. And again, if you want to go back, you just simply double click on the slider, goes back to the initial state. So yeah, that was kind of like what I wanted to touch upon in the Creative Suite. And another thing that I could say here, once you start editing a picture and you want to see how it looked before, you just simply click on the backslash and it just shows you before, and you click again and it goes back where you've left on. Now I will touch upon the third part and the last part, which is the creative delivery. And this is just simply how you're going to export your pictures. So what you want to do is go to file and then export. Then you're gonna have here the file name. If you want to rename it, you just put custom name. If not, you just leave it as it is by default. And then you're gonna have the image format, which is JPEG in this situation, sRGB for the color space. The quality, you want to go all the way up. The resolution, 300 pixels per inch. So yeah, that's about it. And then just click export and the picture has been exported. Now, if you want to crop a picture for Instagram, I will go to crop, which is just here, which is below the histogram. And then I will go to where you have aspect here. I would go to original and then I would choose 4:5. And then I would click on X. So you click on X and that turns into a 4:5. However, this is not usually the best size for Instagram. You actually want to crop slightly. Click done. And what you want to do after is go to file and then export. And then again, I already have a preset here for Instagram. So if you want to add preset, just first set up this the way I have it. So for some reason, the Instagram gods like the quality of 76 on the image format. So I would just choose 76 here, and then 1080 pixels, short edge, click on resize to fit. Then you're gonna select short edge, right? 1080 pixels, and then the resolution at 72 pixels per inch. Sharpen for screen, and that's about it. And once you've done that, just click on add and write the name of the preset, and just simply create, and then it's gonna come up here on the user presets. And then once you want to export it, you just simply right click, export, and Instagram preset will be already there. You don't need to kind of add manually all those settings. And just a few tips in the end as well. Once your picture is done and it's ready to be exported, if you want to look at the final product again, if you press Y, it just separates the before and after. If you press Shift Y, it just kind of like blends in the picture with the before and after. If you want a full preview, you press F and it just gonna load as a full preview. But yeah, that's about it, guys. I mean, this is kind of like the super basic things that you really want to know once you've hit to launch the Lightroom application. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this video, comment and let me know what you think of it, and subscribe if you aren't already. Make sure you hit that notification bell. A lot more tutorials will be coming, including a daily vlog in Finland. I'm really looking forward. 13th of February coming up. If you're already traveling, or if you're planning your next trip, just go explore with your heart open, and I will see you in my next video. Thank you.